down.
And we begin with weather and a wild night as a spring storm leaves parts of our area covered in an icy hail mixture. Take a look at this amazing video of the hail that was coming down on a home in Fairfield, sent in to us by a KCRA3 insider.
Noisy as you were driving, a layer of hail made it look like snow was blanketing ground and also those rooftops. While many people were out enjoying this winter-like weather, others had to clean up the mess it left behind. That wild weather across Northern California has our full focus tonight.
KCRA3 meteorologist Dirk Verdorn tracking how the weather's going to impact your day when you get up tomorrow.
And we begin with KCRA3's Richard Sharp live in Fairfield, where the hail was coming down in bunches.
It was, Edie, very heavily. And take a look at this greenhouse behind me. More than 7 hours after the storm blew by, and still sheets of this slushy hail. It was so heavy, it doesn't look like much, so heavy it crushed this greenhouse. Look how much of this snow-like hail is still here. And this is only part of the damage.
A KCRA3 insider shot this video of the hail. You can hear the thunder in the background. The hail kept falling.
So this is almost an hour after it started hailing.
There was so much hail, the weight crushed two of the five greenhouses at the Castaneda family farm in Fairfield.
We brush it down like this to remove the weight.
Silverio Castaneda and his family couldn't keep up with the hail.
In these greenhouses, about 120,000 plants.
These tiny tomatillos and 80 other species were almost ready to be planted. Now, almost half of his crop is at risk.
Is all of this ruined?
Yes.
From Live Copter 3, you can see the blanket of slushy hail stretching from the fields to the neighborhoods. Kids seize the moment.
This is awesome. This is the first time I've ever seen snow in my life.
People here couldn't decide if it was snow, hail, or
ice.
Do you think it's ice? It's not snow?
No, it's ice.
Is it hail?
No, it's ice.
Back on the farm, the hail may have also ruined entire orchards of fruit trees.
It could ruin the crops because all the little blossoms are out, you know, and the little fruit's already on the trees.
The farmers are going to be back out here tomorrow to see if they can salvage any of this. You can see how long this is, about 100 feet long, 20 feet wide. But let me show you where the plants are. As we bend down here, you can see all the little plants inside here. And this is the damage. All of these might be lost. This farmer says he could lose more than $20,000 in crops from these greenhouses being crushed. Live in Fairfield, I'm Richard Sharp, KCRA 3 19.